And welcome back to another Bob Blast. Hi, I'm Bob Burridge, and this one is about a technique that I like to use in my paintings. And it's all about busy areas and quiet areas. Doesn't sound like something you learn from a book, but it's what I like to do when I look at paintings, and especially when I'm judging paintings. I look for busy areas and quiet areas. When I mean busy areas, this is what I mean by busy area. We're talking chaos. Chaos. It's screaming at you. It's everywhere. There's no place for your eye to settle down. And that's the point of the quiet areas I have over here. Busy areas, quiet areas. I like to put the two in the painting so my eye, look where my eye goes. Goes to the focal point. This one's pretty obvious. Some not so obvious. But at least you see where I'm going with this. Here's a busy area, quiet area. So it doesn't have to be an abstract. Some of the subjects that are more recognizable, busy areas, quiet area. I just like the cadence of da 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 da, da and then ooh, that kind of a thing in the same painting. Don't ask me where that comes from. Now here's something that's halfway recognizable, a subject. Yeah, I like Klimt. You know, and I've always wanted to try his golden techniques with the quiet areas and busy areas. Boy, is he ever a master of that. Try it. It's fun. More of an abstract piece of mine where I like to just do one dominant color, then get really chaotic in one area. But then after looking at all this chaos, I need some rest in the painting. Ah, go out there and rest in the park, and then I can go back in there and play it some more. It's a little fun thing I get to do in the studio. I'm alone in the studio, so it's a crazy game I like to play. Here are more abstracts. This is part of my farmland series on canvas. It's like looking straight down from a jet. You see the flat areas, busy areas. These are the rivers, farmland, stacks of things. On a farm up in here, the same kind of a thing, a little bit different part of the country, but it's all divided up into sections. Busy areas, boy, look at the busy areas. And then, the quiet areas. So let me see if I can do one for you right now. We'll be doing the busy stuff and then the quiet stuff. It's a fun cadence, kind of a dance I like to do in my painting. Hey, let's get started. Yay, I get to paint. Here we go. On my table, my acrylic paints. I have my Kilimanjaro paper from Cheap Joe, 300-pound Kilimanjaro watercolor paper. My crazy brushes, extra long. Wooden sticks taped onto these handles. I like them because they're easier to hold in my hand, like that. If I had to hold onto this skinny stick all day long, my hand would crimp up. So I fatten up my handles. Big wide brushes, tiny little ones for drawings. These are my paints, and I have nice bucket size tubs of acrylic paint. This is the Holbein paint. I can also have the tubes. Over here I have the colors I'm going to be really using mostly. Dominant color will be orangish. This is the black. I'm going to do some drawing into it. At least that's my plan. And a little bit of color blue. Of course, a squirt water bottle. I love my paper towels. Everything's taped down. This is the green frog tape that everybody uses. I'm using this mostly so I have a straight line when I do this abstract painting. When it dries, we'll take the tape off and let's see what it looks like. So that's the reason I use this tape. Okay, so I don't have it on really hard because I want to be able to take it off without tearing off the top surface. All right, the first thing I'm going to do is clear the deck a little bit. Paper towel. It's a paper towel, and I'm going to put a stain, almost like a stain, on top of the surface. So I have a wet paper towel, big buckets of water. I mean big buckets of water. And I just want this to be light at first. This has no gesso. I putting my DNA all over this whole thing. Here we go. Now this paper knows that I'm the boss. At least for a couple minutes. There we go. All right, that's what I wanted to do. So yeah, it's kind of an overall orange painting. Now I'm gonna get this long brush here and stand back and draw a little bit. This is where the chaos comes in. Remember, we're going to have chaotic stuff. And then not so chaotic stuff. I like to draw a lot into the painting from about 2 feet away. I'm basically just showing you the chaos. No real plan. And adding some blue into here now. Whoa. Kind of a dark little thing here. Let's add more water just for fun. More water. Splash. Hey, chaos. And maybe some white. Big dollops of white. Whoa, it lightened up the dark area a whole lot. I'm bringing the blue over here to kind of tie the whole painting together with that chaotic brush stroke. Let's pull it together. It's pretty one-sided, isn't it? Heavy over here, light-hearted over here. I still need to have more of a quiet area. How do I make the area quiet? I make this busier. And louder. And in your face. Whoa. I think Jackson Pollock just rolled over and says, that's not how you do it. So I like the action of this. Now, let's get a focal point in here. Now the focal point, I'm going to also put it in the quiet area. The focal point is exactly the quiet area. Let me add some blue to this. Let's do it right up in here. This is not going to be a long teaching video here. This is one of those paintings that can stop anywhere. And I can keep on painting, you see. So I'm quieting down the quiet areas. So I really will want to go to that one spot. The focal point doesn't always have to be the largest spot. I think Henri Matisse said to make red more noticeable, you may get smaller. What a genius. Look where your eye goes here. Of course your eyes into chaos. And that's the point of this Bob Blast, is to show you chaotic and then quiet areas. Busy areas, quiet areas. And oh, by the way, I put the focal point right there. We'll let this dry, and I'm going to take the tape off, and let's see what it looks like. All right, hang in there. I'll be right back. You recall we started off with frog tape. It's a very nice tape for making straight edges. Let's take a look here. So I taped up the paper, pull it back on itself. See what I'm doing right here, by the way? This is the way you take tape off. You don't rip it off. Take your time. I know you're excited. I'm excited. See? Slowly, and you pull it away from itself because the tape still might be wet. And you don't want to go back into this paper. So what we've created is a pseudo border. Pretty cool. It's a great way to look at your work too, by the way. If it were a border, a mat. It almost looks like a print. Look at that. Because of this good paper, this is the Kilimanjaro 300-pound paper. Look how it takes a straight edge. Isn't that just beautiful? So, let's see what it looks like. like a piece of white paper without all these interferences. There we go. Voila. So what we have here is the busy, chaotic area and the quiet area. And oh, by the way, it becomes the focal point. So that's why I like to paint with busy areas and quiet areas. Just one more thing to play with. Hey, I hope you've enjoyed this video. By golly, I have. And I hope to see you at the next Bob Blast. Keep your brushes wet and juicy. See you later.